made famous by Harvard psychologist Timothy Leary, who, in the 1960s, was studying whether psychedelic drugs could have therapeutic uses. For a lot of reasons, including that he took the drugs along with his student subjects, Leary was fired from Harvard, and LSD, psilocybin, and other hallucinogenic drugs were deemed illegal by the Food and Drug Administration. Fast forward to 2020, psychological research with hallucinogenic drugs is a legitimate field of study again, allowing a handful of medical research organizations to conduct what's called breakthrough therapy with psychedelics. Researchers are looking at whether these drugs can be used to treat depression, anorexia, PTSD, and even alcohol and tobacco dependence. In June, advocates announced they had gathered enough signatures to put in an initiative that would legalize psilocybin-assisted therapy. Meanwhile, Washington, D.C. voters are likely to consider a psilocybin decriminalization measure this fall, following the examples of cities including Denver and Oakland and Santa Cruz, California, which have recently passed similar measures. So what's different about today's research using psychedelics? How do drugs that have long been considered taboo in polite society become tools for treating a growing number of mental health issues? We will be delving into these and other questions that explores the connections between psychological science and everyday life.